Warning, this video contains extremely large amounts of Belgian Dan! Viewer discretion is advised.
Well, hello, 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 welcome to another Belgian Dan video game playthrough video of the video game The Walking Dead. If you haven't played the game yourself, please stop watching these videos and go play it, because I really don't want to spoil it for you. If you haven't watched the previous parts yet, check them out. If you have done all of the above, I just want to say thank you. Thank you very much. So yeah, then we can continue. So let's go.
Ta-da!
Nicely done, Clementine, but you really had me worried there.
Good work, Clem. But don't go shooting off like that without asking first. Okay?
I was just trying to help.
I know, and you did good. You just had me worried there for a minute.
Can we maybe have this conversation inside? My leg's starting to hurt like hell.
We can as soon as Kenny gives the all clear.
Looks okay from here. Everybody in.
Okay. Man, look at his leg. We need to deal with that fast. We also need to find Chuck fast. And we also need to do a room-by-room search to see how secure this place really is. Can't leave that up to luck.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. I'm good. Feel better already just being off my feet. Thanks, babe.
So yeah, lovely new location, huh?
So, when were you going to tell us about the radio?
Tell you what?
That it's working. That there's someone else on the other end of that thing. You didn't think that might have been worth sharing with the rest of us?
I didn't see the point in worrying anyone. Not until I figured out who it was.
I don't like people keeping secrets. I especially don't like it when they think it's for my own good.
Who gives a shit about the damn radio? I'm more worried about whoever it was out there ringing that bell and bringing the dead down on top of us. It's like they didn't want us to make it to the river.
What if they're the same guy?
That doesn't make any damn sense. If it was the same guy, why would he warn us?
Damned if I know. Maybe they were just trying to mess with us. Wouldn't be the most screwed up thing I've seen these past few weeks, I can tell you.
Whoever it was, seems like they're following us. And I don't like being followed.
All the more reason to get on a damn boat where we can't be followed.
I'm not going back out there anytime soon. Omid needs to rest.
Well, I agree with Kenny, but honestly...
We need to make sure Chuck is okay. Once it's quieted down outside, we'll all head towards the river. See if we can find him. Deal?
Suit yourselves, but I'm not gonna wait around too long for someone else to grab up those boats. That's our ticket out of here.
Understandable.
Place seems secure, at least.
I'll feel better when we know that for sure. We need to check the whole house.
All right, fine. You and me will take the upstairs. Lee, you've got down here. Make sure you check every door, understand?
Okay.
Is there anything I can do?
Thanks, I got it. Hang out with Krist and Omid until I get back, okay?
Lee, I'm sorry.
What for?
Going through the door like that without checking first? I guess that was pretty dumb, huh?
Just ask me first the next time you're gonna outsmart all the grown-ups, okay?
Okay.
To be absolutely honest, Clementine, sometimes you're too smart for my own good. Now let's see what's behind door number one. Christ!
What happened?
It's nothing. Just, nothing.
Just a stupid broom that scared the living shit out of me.
Holding up okay?
I hope this house is safe. Have you checked all the rooms to make sure?
No, but I'll take care of it.
Don't worry, Clementine. I'm gonna make sure this place is perfectly safe.
Whoever cleared this place out left behind two bottles of whiskey. Looks like someone didn't have their priorities straight.
Here goes door number two.
All clear in here.
And thank goodness for that.
Just one more to check.
Okay, last door.
That's the last room. Looks like downstairs is secure. Well, place ain't got much. We should be okay here for a while. At least until it quiets down outside.
Good. Thanks.
Don't mention it.
Is he okay?
Yeah, for now. But I'm really worried his leg might have gotten infected. Don't suppose you turned up any meds while you were poking around?
Just some whiskey.
I was just asking Clementine if she knows who the man on her radio is. It's okay, honey. You can tell us. Who is he? What does he want?
It's okay, Clementine.
Go ahead, Clem. It's okay. You're not in any trouble.
It's just a friend. I don't think he wants to hurt us.
What has he been saying to you? What have you been saying to him?
I told him I was trying to find my parents and that they were in Savannah. He really seems nice. I think he wants to help me find them.
Clementine, honey, trust me, that's not what he wants. He...
Lee? Lee, you need to get up here now.
What's wrong?
It's Kenny. Kenny said he thought he heard something up there. Went to go look.
He's up there?
I can't get him to come down.
Stay here.
I really hope Kenny's okay, man. To be absolutely honest, he's the closest thing I have as a friend. We got history together, man. Kenny? Kenny, are you okay, man? Why does it look like a broken doll, man? You okay, man?
Kenny, you okay, man? Oh, Jesus. What the hell is that? Oh, my God.
What the duck?
Kinda looks like Duck, don't he?
It's just a kid. What the hell happened to him?
Ain't nothing on him. Guess he must have been hiding out up here. Starved to death.
Jesus Christ.
I don't know if I can, Lee. Couldn't do it before. Can't do it now.
It's okay, Kenny. You don't have to.
I can't ask you to do this, man. I'll take care of it. Like I did before.
Are you sure?
I guess we'll find out.
Just look at Kenny, man. He really looks like a broken doll. There's no way I can ask him to do that.
This must have been where he slept. Poor kid. Must have tried to hide out up here until he starved to death. This could have been Clementine, if I hadn't found her when I did.
To be honest, thank goodness I found her. What's the most humane way to kill him? Again. I'm sorry, Kenny.
I'm sorry.
May he rest in peace.
We should bury him.
I'll take care of it.